Good morning, children. Today we are going to start chapter 9, Europe, resources and their utilization. So in this chapter we are going to study about the people of Europe, agriculture, animal rearing, minerals and industries, transportation and the major cities of Europe. So coming to people of Europe, there are different races which reside in Europe. So the people of Europe are generally known as Caucasian race. They are of three distinct races: the Alpine people, such as Celts and Gauls, are broad and sturdily built, as you can see here, with medium complexion. Their skin color is not too fair. They are of medium complexion and distinct features like broad facial bones. They mostly inhabit the highland region of southern Europe. Then coming to Nordic people, they are tall, well-built, fair-skinned and blue or grey eyes and light-coloured hair. They have been living in Scandinavia for thousands of years. The Goths, Saxons, Danes, Vandals, Norsemen and Angles belong to the Nordic race. The people of Mediterranean are the people who have settled along the shores of the Mediterranean Sea. Refer to map, children. They are short in height. They have dark eyes and dark hair. Europe is a very densely populated continent with more than 70 persons per square kilometer. But this distribution of population is not even. It differs, it changes from place to place due to the factors like relief. Now, relief means at some places it is a plain land, at some places there is a high land, and at some places there are mountains. So the distribution of population varies from place to place. Then coming to climate also plays a very important role in deciding the distribution of population. The climate is not same everywhere. Near the coastal areas, have maritime type of climate, whereas the interior part of the land has continental type of climate. So there are extremes of climate at some places near the Arctic Ocean. So in these places, the population changes. The population becomes less in places where there are extreme conditions. And utilization of natural resources. Wherever natural resources like the wood of forest, raisins, etc., the transport and communications which can be done, river, etc., they play a very important role in the settling of people. So generally people, they like to live or reside beside a river which flows throughout the year, so that they can get abundant water for irrigation, for transportation, for drinking purpose and for their domestic purpose. So here you can see in this map, the darker areas which are shown in the map are highly populated, densely populated. So in Western Europe, the population is more because of its topography. Topography means the land is flat over here and the land is fertile as many rivers flow through it. There are navigable rivers and trade and manufacturing is done over here. That is why more and more people have settled in these places. So the Netherlands, Belgium have the highest density of population because of their small size. Now these countries like Netherlands and Belgium are very small in size. That is why the population seems to be very high. Other highly populated regions are Rhine Valley, Ruhr Valley of Germany and Lombardy Plain of Italy. The London Basin of United Kingdom, the Paris Basin of France. So here you can see all the places which are green in color are the basins of the rivers where population is densely populated. Now cities like London, Moscow, Paris, Amsterdam, Naples, Vienna, Rome, Frankfurt have the highest density of population among the European cities. Now, moderately populated regions are found in the plateau areas in the regions where agriculture is practiced. Sparsely means very less population. Regions are found in the tundra and taiga regions of Eastern Europe near the Urals and Caspian Sea. The population is less than 10 persons per square kilometer in these regions. So sparsely populated means all the northern part of the continent, which is near the Arctic Ocean, which is shown in light yellowish color, is sparsely populated. Why? Because there are extremes of temperature. It is very cold throughout the year. It is almost frozen throughout the year. That is why the people, they live in a scanty manner over here. Now, coming to natural resources, Europe is one of the most developed continents. This is because it has plenty of natural wealth, excellent climatic conditions, and hard-working, resourceful people who make the best possible use of nature's provisions. As Europe is the most developed continent because of its natural wealth such as soil, minerals, forest, etc., and excellent climatic conditions, as it has a long coastline, the most of the areas have moderate type of temperature, which is suitable for the people to work endlessly without tiring. And the people over there are very resourceful, they are hardworking, and they make best possible use of the natural resources. Next comes water. Europe has plenty of water supply because of the rivers and streams. You can see all these which are in blue are the rivers. So it is many navigable and perennial rivers flow through Europe from the mountains into the plains. These streams are used for irrigation, which has helped in industrial development of the continent. The swiftly flowing rivers have been harnessed to generate hydroelectricity in the mountainous region. Now children, the perennial rivers are used for irrigation. Irrigation means the fields where crops are grown are artificially watered. So that is known as irrigation. So this has helped in industrial development of the continent. Now when the crops are grown, it is processed in the industries, it is packed in the industries, and which gives employment to many people, and this is how the development of the continent has taken place. Now the swiftly flowing rivers, swift flowing means from the mountainous region, when the rivers, they flow in a zigzag manner and endlessly, they flow with a great force, and that at that time hydroelectricity, the electricity that we use for various purposes, for various appliances, that hydroelectricity, hydro means from water electricity is generated itself in the mountainous region and then it is supplied in the whole continent. As you can see in the map, there are brown features which show the mountainous region of Europe and the swift flowing rivers which flow from here. They are used for generating hydroelectricity. The European countries like France, Spain, Italy, Switzerland, Norway and Sweden have made remarkable progress in hydropower production. These plants have built across rivers in the mountainous area. Many rivers are interconnected by canals and are used for navigation. The fertile silt deposited by rivers has encouraged agriculture. Now children, hydro power production plants have been built across the rivers. Actually, dams and barrages are built across the rivers to check the flow of water of the river so that it may not flood the nearby areas and to regulate the flow of water. Hydro electricity is also produced and water is supplied for irrigation purpose. The rivers, as there are many rivers which flow through this area, so what happens that it is connected through canals. All the rivers are interconnected by canals and it is used for navigation purpose. Navigation means one can ply boat in these rivers and can go from one place to other. So these rivers, as they are perennial and they flow throughout the year from the mountainous regions to the plain, they bring fertile soil with them. Next, children, is about forest. I would like you to see the tundra and the taiga regions. Now, this is the tundra region which is shown in the map in yellow. It is in the extreme north of Arctic Ocean. So, as it is in the extreme north of the continent, it is always frozen with ice. So, there are very few vegetation found in this area. Vegetation is negligible. Then coming to taiga region, just below tundra lies the taiga belt. Now, taiga belt is a belt of dense coniferous forest. Coniferous, you know, the cone-shaped forest. So, it is found at a higher altitude on the mountainous region. So, over here, this is the taiga region. Now, coming to the topic forest. Forest of taiga belt in Norway, Sweden, Russia, and Finland produce wood which is used for manufacture of paper, furniture, turpentine, rayon and other synthetic fibers and resins. The coniferous trees of this region provide softwood. The wood is not very hard. On the German-Swiss border, traditional skills of wood carving and clockmaking are combined to produce the world-famous cuckoo clocks. The cork oak of the Mediterranean countries of Spain and Portugal yields cork. The mixed forest belt consists of hardwood deciduous trees which yield timber for construction, shipbuilding and making trawler and fishing boats. Now, coming to soil resources, different types of soils are found over Europe due to variation in climatic conditions, parent rock, drainage and rate of decomposition of plant remains. The soil is acidic and waterlogged due to the presence of permafrost in the tundra region and hence useless for agriculture. Podzols are found over the coniferous forest region of the taiga climatic belt. These soils are also acidic, leached of minerals, and water accumulates due to permafrost. These are not workable soils. A wide region covering central Russia, southern Norway, Finland, Pyrenees and Alps up to Great Britain and Ireland are covered by podzols and brown forest soil in the mixed forest region. The best soils, Chernozems, are found over the steep grassland region. These soils are deep friable, very rich in humus and very fertile. Friable means can be easily broken or crumpled. Now, alluvial soils are found over the lowlands. These soils are fertile and suitable for agriculture. These soils are brought down by the great rivers. Agriculture or the growing of crops is of prime importance and is carried out in accordance with the most modern and scientific techniques. As European countries are considered as rich countries, so they have enough money to buy the scientific machines and modern machines and to use scientific techniques. So they grow crop by using different sorts of scientific techniques. Intensive farming is carried in the Mediterranean region. As Mediterranean region is densely populated, many people live in this region due to favorable climatic conditions and soil conditions. So over here, the land part for doing farming becomes less. So intensive farming is done. Small farms and large labor force ensure that most of the work is done manually. Now, as they have very small, not very small, but small patch of land where they can't use huge machines. So, and the labor that they get for agriculture is large. So, all the work is done manually with hand. The yield per hectare is high owing to the use of improved seeds, insecticides, fertilizers, and rotation of crops. Now, what is the meaning of rotation of crops? Once the cereal crops are grown, then again pulses are grown, which are considered as leguminous crops, which have nodules in their root, which supply nitrogen to the soil and make it fertile. So this is called rotation of crops. Once cereal crops are grown, then pulses, and again cereal crops are grown, and again pulses are grown. So this is called rotation of crop. Extensive farming. Now, the places which has low density of population, extensive farming is done, where machines are used for all the purpose, the different type, uses. Like it is practiced in great European plains, and more land is available for cultivation. Different types of crops are cultivated in these regions, as there are different kinds of soil and climate. Use of machinery becomes necessary on farms in these areas, which cover thousands of hectares. As I have told you, that the land is more and the population is less, so the work can't be done manually with hand. So they use huge machines, and it becomes necessary to use machines in their farms. So hybrid seeds, hybrid means the seeds which are of good quality, which produce more, which gives more yield, are hybrid seeds. Fertilizers and crop protection measures are used for greater productivity in Russia and in the steep grasslands. Mixed farming is popular in the densely populated areas where both animals are reared and the crops are cultivated on the same farm. So the farmer, he produces crops in the farms, and the leftover part of the crop he gives to the cattle, which he keeps at his home. So they are the domesticated animals to whom he feeds, and he gets double profit. From the crops also he gains profit, and from the animals also, by selling their milk products, he gets enough profit. And this is called mixed farming. This type of farming is common in Europe. Animals are reared and crops are cultivated on the same farm to substitute the income of the farmer in case of loss of crops. Sometimes when the there are natural disasters, then the crops may fail to produce cereals or food. So what happens at that time, he has animals which can give him a substitute to his income. Animals are raised for meat, milk, and are reared on farm waste. In some countries like Netherlands, land has been reclaimed from undersea by building dikes or iron embankments and by pumping out standing water along the coast. This is called polder and is used for farming. So the places which are near the sea, they are always filled with water. So the farmers have utilized that part by pumping out water from that land and by building an embankment, a barrier along the coast, so that they can use that area for farming, and that is called polder. Next is food crops. A large variety of food, fodder, and cash crops are grown depending upon the soil fertility and climatic conditions. Fodder means, children, the food which is given to the cattle, especially agricultural products. Or you may say that the leftover crop or stalks of the crops. Now, food crops are grown such as wheat, barley, rye, maize, oats, potatoes, beans and peas. Oats and rye is grown as food and fodder crops. Wheat is oats are and rye are, children, inferior type of crops which are given to the cattle as food. Wheat is cultivated over the steppes of Russia, Ukraine, Belgium, Netherlands, Germany and England. Maize is cultivated in the drier southern parts of Europe. After extracting the juice, sugar beet remains are fed to the animals. Barley is grown mainly for making beer. Potato is mostly grown in France, Poland, Netherlands, Germany and Ireland. Now coming to cash crops. Cash crops are sugar beet, hemp, flax, tobacco. Flax fiber is used for making linen cloth and is grown in areas around the Baltic Sea. Rye is ground to make a type of bread. Large quantities of fruits like grapes, apples, peaches, figs, olives, and citrus fruits are grown in the Mediterranean region. Grapes are produced for viticulture. Viticulture means where grapes are grown. Or wine making and making raisins. Viticulture is common in Germany, France, Spain and Italy. Horticulture, or the cultivation of fruits and flowers on a commercial scale, is also a common practice. Netherlands is famous for tulips and Bulgaria is famous for its roses. Market gardening is practiced on the outskirts of large cities and towns. Fresh vegetables, fruits and flowers are cultivated on small farms intensively for profit. The produce is sent by truck to the city markets in the wee hours. Wee hours means early in the morning. Hence, it is also called truck farming. animal rearing. Dairy farming is done in areas of mixed farming. The damp and cool climate and natural pastures with nutritious grasses are most suitable for keeping cattle. The animals are also fed on fodder crops cultivated on the farms. Cattle is reared for dairy products as well as for meat. Milk producing cattle or milch cattle are reared for milk. Milk products such as cheese, cream, butter and condensed milk. Netherlands, Denmark, Belgium, France and United Kingdom are world famous for their dairy industry. Dairy cooperatives have linked the farmers with buyers. Dairy cooperatives organize the collection of milk and the processing into various types of milk products like cream, butter, cheese, condensed milk and powder milk. The cooperatives also market these products. Sheep and goats are reared in southern and eastern Europe, dry parts of Mediterranean, British Isles and the Balkan countries for milk, meat and wool. In the warmer and drier areas around the Mediterranean, farmers keep goats. Cheese made from goat's milk is very popular in countries like Greece. Pigs are kept for the production of pork and its products. Horses are used for work on farms. Poultry farming is done in many parts of the continent for production of eggs and meat. Reindeer farms are common in the northern parts of Europe, where they are reared for meat, fur, milk and as a means of transport. Coming to fisheries, the fishing industry in Europe is highly developed due to the presence of shallow seas and continental shelves, mixing of warm and cold currents and the production of plankton. Now children, as Europe has a long coastline and the water is not very deep because there are many shells, continental shells beneath. So over here the mixing of warm and cold current also takes place, which gives rise to planktons. It is a fish feed. The fishes, they feed on planktons and that is why they get attracted to it and they come in huge schools. They are caught by the people and fishing ports and harbors have been developed on the indented coastline. Indented means broken. Dodger Bank and the Great Fisher Bank are important fishing grounds of the western coast of Europe. The main countries for fishing are Norway, Sweden, Denmark, Netherlands, France, Germany, UK, Spain and Portugal. Fishing has become highly technical with large fishing vessels having canning, curing, refrigeration facilities. These vessels are called floating factories and the catch is processed on the ship itself. Vessels means these big ships, they are known as floating factories and the fishes that they catch is processed on the ship. Halibut, cod, herring, mackerel and sardines, these are the names of the fishes, are caught in large numbers. Fishing is done on a large commercial scale so much so that now governments have brought in restrictions in order to prevent overfishing in any one region. Norway, Denmark, England, Russia, Poland and Spain lead the countries of Europe in this industry.